Innovate or get left behind. Innovation is key to a thriving economy, and one need look no further than Canada for an example. And the 10th anniversary of Canadarm2 illustrates this. Chris Hatfield was one of two astronauts who installed Canadarm2 back in 2001.
Building things in space is incredibly complicated. There's no perspective. You go from incredible blackness to incredible brightness of the sun in just a few seconds. And so the Canadarm has been thrust in the middle of that in order to build the space station, to retrieve things from the space shuttle or from Canadarm1 on the shuttle, to then manipulate them through the incredibly detailed and confusing environment of the three dimensions around the space station, and then so carefully install them into the right place on board.
Built for the Canadian Space Agency by MDA of Brampton, Canadarm2's role will expand as the construction of the ISS finishes. In addition to all its current work, the arm will make more and more cosmic catches, a breathtaking move where it reaches out and grasps a spacecraft and docks it to the ISS. Canadian Space Agency's president, former astronaut Steve McLean, also the first Canadian to operate Canadarm2, explains the significance of Canada's contribution to the International Space Station.
Canadarm2 is a great example of Canadian technology leadership that has become our legacy. Canadarm2 is at the heart of a series of other manipulators, Canadarm1 and Dextra, that with the construction of the International Space Station, we have shown ourselves to make operations more efficient. And in addition, after Columbia, with the addition of Canadarm boom extension and the sensors that go with that, we've also showed that our manipulator operations are making flight safer. This is our legacy.
In addition to allowing our country to send astronauts into space, Canada's investment in the International Space Station provides opportunities for Canadian scientists on this exceptional orbiting lab to investigate issues that may benefit Canadians in diverse areas such as cardiovascular health, neurology, and the science of aging. Martin Vanderwood reporting.